Yeah, I see what I do as an archaeology of the present, and it means that I'm taking things that are very mundane and very ordinary and put them in a context that slightly shifts their meaning and gives a perspective into consumer society. I really work with consumer display and with shop windows and anything that signifies consumption and capitalism. And it can go into oil production, it can go into sort of militaristic advertising and propaganda, and it really takes on different forms and shapes in my work. When I started out at CalArts as a student, we mainly read critical theory, and so that was actually the foundation for the work that I later made. So it kind of all started there, and then the works that I started making after school were somewhat rooted in that kind of critical theory thinking. And I think that as an artist, or at least I feel that for me it's more interesting to talk about like the present and like what it means to be a human being in the year 2012 and what kind of makes up our culture, and whether that's political is in a way open to interpretation. I think there is a certain sense of responsibility as an artist to also engage with politics. The windows to me mean that people who don't usually look at art can get a sense of something that is slightly different, and it doesn't even have to be art. It's just that they walk by and they see the facade and they don't really know exactly, is this some kind of weird store, or is it a gallery, or is it from a different culture? So it kind of, I like the idea of sort of blurring the line between like an elitist kind of art context and the general sort of culture. The idea for me is really that they are more meant to be like targets for sort of violent action, and they represent the moment of when like a shop like a shop window is attacked by a demonstrator, and it's not really about glorifying or celebrating the consumer display, but it's more setting it in context with an oppositional force, and so it's really more like a vocabulary of the present. Well, it's more kind of like a futurist archaeologist, you know, it's really, I mean, in some ways the work is really meant for like future viewers and to kind of get a sense of what our lives were about in this time and age.